hey, what's up? I went to E3 2018 this year, and I thought I should go ahead and throw together a video of my experience. I didn't want to end up like last year when I went to Anime Expo, recorded a bunch of footage and didn't even use it. So here's a video on that. I just went as a normal person, not press or anything like that. And this is the time I had. I arrived on Sunday. My first stop was EA Play. I had a scheduled appointment to check out Anthem. Now, I thought I was going to get some hands-on time with it, like to play a demo. But all you do is just go into a booth, a nice little air-conditioned tent, and they do a live-action playthrough of the demo for you. So I was a little bit disappointed, but it looked pretty cool. It's pretty much Destiny with robots. I'll check it out. So here I am just walking down, there's the Anthem tent there, and then a little bit further down is Battlefield. They have some mobile games like the Command & Conquer, the food trucks over there. And closer to the entrance, they had a Battlefield and a live stage where some annoying guy was talking. I kind of ignored him and just kept on going. And to the left there, there's a theater. I didn't actually go inside there, but I'm guessing they played trailers of upcoming EA games. Here's the intro. I came here on Saturday. I think this was Sunday. I went to go ahead and pick up my badge. I was very surprised because when I came to Anime Expo, there was like a super long line. I stood in line for like a few hours just to get my badge, and here you could just walk straight up and get it. So that was very nice. Even Monday when I came by, it still wasn't very crowded. Like, this is footage from Anime Expo. This is, see the difference between this and the E3 line. Although granted, I did come somewhat late on the first day, but still, it was like way different. And that's like the same area in the back there, but as you can see, there's no crowd or anything. Nice and smooth. On Monday, I went to the PC Gamer Show, and this was a pretty small theater, and it wasn't even packed. Like, I don't watch the PC Gaming Show because it's boring, but I figured, hey, I can get into it. I couldn't get into Microsoft or Bethesda because I waited too long.
Will you please welcome my very good friend, Mr. Todd Howard.
Here comes the money. Money.
So I wanted to head and check this one out. And you're much better off watching it at home. See, this is the experience you got if you watch the PC Gamer Show trailer at home. If even one person here commits a sin. And this is the view I got. Nice little crane action blocking the shot. It kept coming down over and over during the show. So it really wasn't worth my time going, both because the PC Gaming Show was bad and because of this. So I had an appointment to watch the PlayStation Experience live. So I went ahead and cut out a little bit earlier. Now, this is Sony's booth where they were selling merchandise. I didn't end up buying anything here, but they have some pretty cool shirts and toys and whatnot here. I was kind of tempted to get this Death Stranding mug. I think it's coming up here in the video, but I didn't. Thankfully, I did not buy any of it. So this is footage from the PlayStation Experience. They had—I didn't go to like the actual PlayStation press conference. But they did let us go into theaters. Every year they have some theaters that they rent out and you can go in and watch with people. So this is me watching with a crowd. It was kind of cool. This is when people were piling in. The conference hadn't started yet, and this is when Resident Evil played. Like the most hyped game of E3 for me. And the crowd here was really getting into it. And this is where people were lining up for day one of E3, which technically started on Tuesday and the press conferences were on Monday. It was actually pretty smooth. When I first got there, I was afraid I was going to have to stand in line out in the hot sun, but thankfully they let us come down into the parking lot, and that little band playing themes. And this is right before they let us in. They had people chanting E3. I missed like the footage earlier when both sides were doing it, but my phone didn't record because I didn't hit the button properly. Now, I had been waiting about 2 hours at this point, but honestly, I could have came in probably half an hour earlier, and it wouldn't really have made a difference, because you could line up in any of those lines, and that side over there was the last to fill up. So if I just came in late, I could have just got in the first batch. But here's the actual show floor. My initial intention was to walk the whole floor and get footage, but I quickly realized I'd better get in line for something. I wanted to do Kingdom Hearts 3, which is right there, but there was like no way I was getting there. Tomb Raider was also full, no way I was gonna get there. So I was kind of like, well, let me see what else is here. So I make a beeline towards the back. And there's the RPD booth. It looked pretty cool. I didn't know where the line was. I was gonna walk right through the front. I was like, no, that can't be right. So I was looking to the left and right, and I saw there was a lot of people there. So I was like, no, I'm probably not getting into that. Oh, here's a Dragon Quest 14. I'm talking about this first. Or Dragon Quest 11. I've never played a Dragon Quest game. I like the art style because it's made by the guy who makes Dragon Ball Z, but the games themselves have never really appealed to me. So I did try out the demo. It was okay. So I went and played Final Fantasy 14, the trial. I was actually kind of excited. Well, not excited, but I've done two of those. I went to FanFest, two FanFests. So I got my my Odin shirt and my Titan shirt. So I wanted to get the new one here for the new trial. And the team behind me, the people behind me, they were like really into Final Fantasy 14. They were going on about classes, how to play and everything. So I was kind of like, hey, man. Look at the numbers. It's 8 people per team. So looking at the numbers, I'm going to be teamed up with these guys. So I'm definitely going to get my shirt, right? And then we get out there, and I get teamed up with the group in front of them because some people, I guess, went ahead. So I'm kind of like, oh, that kind of sucks, but I'll probably be okay. And then the guy right next to me is like, I've never played this game before. And I'm like, oh, God damn it. And then it was like immediately the lady behind me was kind of like, oh, I'm with these guys over here. I'm with these guys. I'm not with this group. I'm like, oh, man, well, maybe we'll be okay. You know, he's going to be DPS. All he has to do is DPS. We'll be fine. We get there. We totally wipe. Like, just bad. I didn't even really know the fight. I did it once just to get cleared on the actual game. But we didn't even get past like a DPS check. We had to defeat a bunch of ghost spirit things or whatever. We just failed miserably. So I ended up having to come back again a while later. But then we did it like no problem, first try. So I was very happy I got my shirt for that. Here's Smash. I had a scheduled time to see Smash. I was able to just walk straight in. No line, no waiting, just walk straight in and play it. I'm not really a big Smash guy. I played Brawl a lot. No, not Brawl, was it Melee? On GameCube a lot. I had company come over, we played the hell of a lot of that game. But the last few games I haven't really played very much, so I was kind of interested in Brawl, but it's not my game of E3, it's not the thing I was hyped for. I think this is after, no, it was right before I played. So yeah, they had all the characters there that you could play in the demo. I think I played Link, Cloud, and Ridley. And then exiting the booth. I went to the PlayStation side, but they didn't really have anything all that interesting over there. Pretty much they had some VR demos. I think a big stage and some Destiny stuff. This is the Marvelous booth. I just saw this. I was like, oh, I gotta get this hunt footage. Inside, they have a bunch of their games. I don't really play that much. I mean, I played Cinnamon Cobra. That's why I got this footage here, but I don't really know what titles they have beyond that. So next, I go poke my head in there. They had Gungrave VR, which I wanted to try, but I didn't want to wait in line for it. And a bunch of other titles that are not really my cup of tea. Yeah, so this is the Shadow of the Tomb Raider booth. I did not get to play that at the show. I tried waiting in line for it, but it kept filling up. So they let a group go in, then you have to wait 30 minutes or so. Then they let another group in. I almost got in. I was like two or three people back, and I couldn't get in. So I decided not to waste time with it. The game's coming out anyway. I'm going to buy it. So there's like Call of Duty. This is a Sony's like demos trial thing. There's Call of Duty 4, which is pretty easy to get to. And on the other side, there's Destiny 2. And I played some Soul Calibur 4 or 6. Yeah. That's a lot like Soul Calibur. I was really happy that Zaza Lamel is back. He is my main guy in 3. I didn't really mess with Geralt. I think I picked him once, but I didn't understand how he played. So this is a game I'm looking forward to. I'm not like hype for it, but you know, I'm probably gonna get it. I played all the other ones, why not? It can't be as bad as 5. Over there, they had a bunch of the Shonen Jump games that are not my cup of tea. This was Assassin's Creed Odyssey. Which I didn't play, but I didn't play Origins either, so. Going further down, there's the Bethesda booth. They had Fallout 76, Rage 2, Elder Scrolls, Blades, and probably a few other games. I didn't really play anything there. They did have this pretty cool Doom Eternal statue that I went by, got a picture of. But I couldn't really tell where the lines were, the lineup for stuff. I think we see some people over there at that display. I think that was like packed, so I couldn't get in there. So I walked around, and there's like this Rage ice cream truck. I didn't know what that was about. There was some kind of Smash game and stuff, so I just kind of wandered around. These are people playing the new Destiny expansion, The Forsaken. I like Destiny 2, but I'm not playing that again. Here's some people that were drawing on the car. This was pretty much the end of day one. They closed at around 7, so this was 6 something. I was on my way out, so I saw some people drawing on a car with a marker. I have no idea who these guys are. Maybe you do. So I just kind of, it's kind of neat. I have no idea what this was for. I think this was day 2. Again, Kingdom Hearts was packed, and so was Tomb Raider, so I went straight to Anime Souls, which is right by Soul Calibur. Decided to give that a try. Seems like a pretty fun game. I couldn't figure out how to lock onto things, but it seems like something I'll play. I have this game pre-ordered. I was going to cancel the pre-order, but after playing it, I think I'll give it a shot. Hopefully you can customize your character, though, because I don't like the way the main guy looks. This was the RE2 booth, the other side. You can take a photo op with the zombies in the police car. This is a Street Fighter V. They had that on display, and this was like a display case next to the arcade machines. I didn't know Cody was playable. I would have done that. So I saw some of these. They look kind of cool. And I saw those pants before online, but they were like $100 and something. I'm not paying that for that. I really like this Cammy statue, but I imagine that's probably $100, $200 also. No. And there's Ono, the guy who made Street Fighter V, doing autographs. I think at this point I was standing in line for Skull and Bones, but it was a 3-hour line. When I got in line, some guy said it was 3 hours, but I figured I must have misheard him, right? Then after an hour and a half, I'm still standing in line. I was like, okay, time to go. There was the esports arena. I didn't pay much attention to that. More Kingdom Hearts, which I didn't get to play, but hey, I'm gonna buy that game anyway, so I guess it doesn't really matter. this was the Sony stage. They didn't really have that much there. So I went and checked out Microsoft's thing, which is at the Microsoft Center, which is kind of like across the street or a little ways down from the actual convention center. I heard when I was standing in line for a game that they had a Kingdom Hearts and Tomb Raider there. So I was thinking to myself, well, I can't get there on the main E3 show floor. Maybe I can get it at this event, right? So I go over there, no dice. People were lined at it, both spots. I went to the Tomb Raider line thinking, hey, this is not too bad. And the guy told me, hey, come back in 2 hours. I was like, oh okay. Well, that was a bust. They had some kind of mini game you could do there to get a temporary tattoo, mind you. And you can get a gold coin for Sea of Thieves, and you can possibly get like a discount code for games and whatnot, but I don't actually own an Xbox One, so I don't actually care about Xbox. You know, I might play some Gears 5, and I still need to play Gears 4, and if Halo gets ported to PC, I'm definitely going to play that, but I don't really care that much. So I checked that out and left. And that was pretty much it. So yeah, the price for the pass is $250, which I really don't think is worth it, because you don't actually get anything. I mean, you just get a badge, that's it. There's no goodie bags, there's no t-shirt, there's no special coupons, just a badge. And you can go to PAX or Anime Expo or pretty much any convention, pay half that price and still get in. So if you're considering going to this next year or the year after that or whatever, and the price is still $250, I don't know. I mean, I don't regret spending the money because I've always wanted to go to E3 and I've gone. So if you're like me, hey, go ahead and go spend the money. But if you're looking for value for your money, probably E3 isn't the best choice. You know, a lot of people will try and discourage you and say, hey, you'll just be standing in line for 2-3 hours just to see one game. But if you've been to any large convention, that's how they all are. You spend in line for a long time and don't really get to do anything. So it's not really that much different. If you're used to that, I would say go ahead and check it out. Now, for my personal games of show, what I'm most excited about that I've seen at this E3, easily Resident Evil 2 Remake is number one. Can't wait to play that. I guess I say Devil May Cry 5 is number two. I liked DMC Devil May Cry, so I had no problem with that, but a lot of people didn't like it, so this is a bit of a return to form, but I like either version. The Last of Us 2, I didn't think The Last of Us was all that great, but I did enjoy it, and the sequel looks pretty good. Sekiro Shadows Die Twice looks pretty hot. I can't wait to play that. And lastly, I guess Tomb Raider. So thank you for watching my video.
All right, sweet.